learners, welcome to your favorite program, Learn at Home. My name is Haruna Yerima Manase, your agri-science teacher. Today, we want to look at a topic that says balanced diet. Balanced diet. Have you ever taken food? Can you mention the type of food you have been taking at home? Maybe in the morning, in the afternoon, in the night, or in the evening, type of food you are taking. Then, we are going to look at the meaning of balanced diet. When we're talking of balanced diet, what do we mean by the word balanced diet? By definition, we said balanced diet is that meal that contains all the classes of food in a correct proportion. Correct proportion. If I may ask you, can you mention the classes of food that we have? You must have learned from your teachers in the school. You discover that we have six classes of food. We have the carbohydrate, we have the protein, we have vitamin, we have mineral salt, we have water, and these are the six classes of food that we have so far. Then, we said any meal you are preparing must contain these classes of food in equal proportion or correct proportion. Now, let's look at the classes of food that I've just mentioned. We say carbohydrate. When we're talking of carbohydrate, we mean energy-giving food. Energy-giving food. Then protein. Protein is a bodybuilding food, a food that builds our body. Then we talk about fat and oil. Fat and oil give energy to the body also. It serves as energy-giving food. Then we have vitamins, are required in very little quantity in the body. They also build our blood group or the blood in our system. They also build our blood in order to prevent germs or any antibody that will come in to our body. Then mineral salt and water. Mineral salt also work on the bones and the teeth. Then water help in regulating the food we are taking in order to cause digestion, to make digestion effective. Then it also regulates our body temperature. Let's look at them one after the other. Carbohydrate, as I've earlier said, is a body energy-giving food. Well, they are energy-giving food, such as you can see we have our yam as one of the examples, and cassava, one of the examples. If you are taking yam, know you that you are taking what we call carbohydrate. Then if you are taking cassava, know you that you are taking what we call carbohydrate. We have some example under this, not only this one alone. We also have things like cocoyam is part of a carbohydrate. You see, if you are taking garri, you know garri is part of a carbohydrate because it's being processed from cassava. And if you are taking amala, amala also is being processed from yam, that's yam flour. So let's tell you that once you are taking amala, you are taking what we call carbohydrate. So also eba, if you are taking eba, eba is being processed through cassava, it's also a carbohydrate food. So also, if you are taking akpu as a food, it's being processed from cassava. It's also one of the class, one of the example of a carbohydrate. Then the next one is protein. We say it's a bodybuilding food. Example as follows. We have milk. Milk is one of the proteins. We can get it from cow, we can get it from goat, and the rest of the animals. So the milk we are taking, it helps in building our body. And also, we have fish or fishes. If you can feed on fishes, they are also in the class of protein. So also, we have some examples like meat. If you are eating meat, it's part of protein that builds our body. And also, we have things like beans or cowpea. It's also part of those crops that if you take them, they are the food that build up your body. Then, the next one is fat and oil. The next one is fat and oil. Have you ever seen fat oil in your house? Maybe vegetable oil, or palm oil, or granite oil. All these oil that you are seeing there, they are in the classes of fat and oil. Then under this, we say they are also energy-giving food. They are also energy-giving food. Then we have vitamin. The example under the fat and oil, as I've mentioned, we have granite. Granite is part of it. Granite, you can extract oil there. The oil, the granite oil or the vegetable oil that you are using, they are the examples of fat and oil. Then we have vitamins. Vitamins are required in very little quantity in the body. You can see these are vitamins, fruits. Any fruit you are taking, be it mango, be it orange, be it watermelon, whatsoever, any type of fruit you are taking, and some of the vegetables, they form part of this mineral, this kind of class of food, that is vitamin. So the next one is minerals, mineral salt. Mineral salt, as I've earlier said, no matter what, if they cook food, they must put Maggi, they must put salt. All these salt, they're in the class of mineral. So also, things like banana and stockberry, they are also example of mineral salt. From banana, we can get mineral salt that helps in building our bones and also build our teeth. These are the function of mineral salt. Water, which is the last class of the classes of food, we have water helps in regulating body temperature and also aids the digestion of food that we're taking. That's why most of the time, if you are eating, water must be on ground. This water, after you have eaten, you will drink water to aid the digestion of the food. And also, maybe you have walked under the sun. As you come, you discover that your body is very hot. You would like to take water to cool down the body temperature. So it regulates the body temperature as well. It also helps in digestion of food. You can see here, this is a glass of water. So we do take it to aid digestion and regulation of temperature. We want to look at the importance of this balanced diet, one after the other. We say it ensures better growth. It ensures better growth. As you are taking it, you discover that you grow well. That's why we say it's a bodybuilding food. That's why there are some food they recommend for children so that they'll take it at their growth. So it ensures better growth. Number two, it says it provides enough energy for work and play. For you to be able to go out there and play, you must have eaten. For you to go and play football, you must have eaten. For you to do your house chores, you must have eaten. For you to go for an errand, you must have eaten. Because the food that you have taken will give you the energy to do that work that you want to do. But when there is no food in your stomach, there will be trouble. You will not be able to do the work you want to do. So by taking this balanced diet, we're not talking of an unbalanced diet. We said balanced diet. It will enable you to get energy and at the same time go about playing with your friends. The next one, we say it prevents illness. There is unnecessary illness will not come your way. Sickness will not come your way. If you are taking a balanced diet, it do prevent illness. The next point says, it keeps the body healthy, thereby making us live longer. Making us live longer. So the body, it keeps it healthy, and at the same time, you will live longer if you are taking balanced diet. Once you are taking balanced diet, it enables your body to be healthy, and you yourself, you will live longer. It helps to maintain the tissues and organs of the body. Yes, we have tissues in our body, in our system. There are organs in our systems. As we are taking balanced diets, it helps to maintain all these tissues and the organs that we have in our bodies. So there is need for you and I to be taking balanced diet so that we will live healthy. Then the next one says, it helps the different parts of the body to function well, all the parts of the body, because you are taking your balanced diet, it helps you to all the parts of your body to function well. Having said this, let's look at, we have talked about the meaning of balanced diet, we have seen the classes of food, and we have seen how they work in the body, and we have seen the importance of these balanced diets to our body, to human being. Then we want to look at, or human being and animal, because animals will need it. We want to look at the evaluation now. Can you define balanced diet? What do we say is balanced diet? By definition, we say balanced diet is a class of food that contains all the classes of food that you are prepared, or a meal you are prepared that contains all the classes of food. And then mention at least the classes of food that you know. We know that we have six classes of food. We have mentioned them. We say carbohydrates, protein, vitamin, fat and oil, mineral salt, and water. These are the classes of food that we have. Then assignment, find out the effect of unbalanced diet. Find out the effect of unbalanced diet in when you are not taking balanced diet. What will happen to you? Then if we meet next time, we'll discuss on it. Stay safe and many thanks. I remain your Agri-Science teacher, Haruna Manasseh Yerima. Mm-hmm.